G'day, how are you? So I'm going to be doing some whiting fishing today. A couple of beautiful diver outfits I got. And so come and join me and see how I go. As I said, my main objective is to get a whiting. That's my main thing, my main target is to go for a whiting. So some beach worms that I got earlier on. Beautiful beach worms. So you can catch them yourself or you can buy them. Look, hey, at the end of the day, the average angler just hasn't got the time. Even if they didn't know how to catch beach worms, they just don't have the time to go and catch them. So sometimes you've got to go and buy them. Anyway, first cast, I struck a rock. Lost a rig. First cast. Yes, you do get snags on beaches. Those Sydney beaches become so eroded that you end up rocks, snags. There's only so much sand on standing on here. Underneath that, it becomes rockier and rockier and rockier. Anyway, I've got to cast at a different spot now. That. I reckon that'd be a good 36 centimeter fish, I reckon. Yeah. Nice solid fish that. Look at that. Sweet. So that whiting, a fraction under 36 centimetres. So, let's start. So, something I want to show you briefly as well. The Bellissimo Tool Paternoster. So I designed this Paternoster myself. I've been using it for the last over two decades. So it's just one length of line. From the leader to the bottom of the swivel to the swivel bomb and that leader below it as well, okay? And then you've got your clip, so that means you can vary your size sinker as well, all right? So you can see on my YouTube the Bellissimo improved Paternoster rig. Check it out. Thank you. So I'm using a number two hook, and that nearly stops it all the way down. You get told to use hooks that are size 6 or 8. Don't use 6 or 8, mate. It's not necessary. Size, even a size 1, I even go to a 1.0 sometimes. I think a 1.0 for whiting. Yeah, the big enough whiting, like a 30 centimetre fish, mate, not a problem. But if you go down to a size 6 or an 8, you just get a hook deep all those undersized fish. Fish about 32, 31, 32 centimetres.
Beautiful.
Sweet. What a start. Two nice whiting. So, nod to me, camera person, do we keep this or not? No, it's a throwback. Okay. Anyway, a nice bit. Probably seen those bites, most people would have struck at that. Why strike at it? It's only small fish. If you get into the habit of striking too soon, you'll find that your hookup ratio will be less. And it could compel you into using smaller hooks too. It might encourage you to use smaller hooks for that reason. Whiting, I reckon. Ooh, yeah. Ooh. 2 or 1? Oh yeah. Sweet. Nice whiting. Well, there you go, another 36 centimeter fish. Look bigger. It's a bulkier fish. If you get any whiting, it's basically over 32 or 34 centimeters. It's a quality fish. It's not just about having the best bait, live worms or live yaddies, or, you know, it's about fishing correctly as well. It's not about being in the right spot, in the right time. And that's got lots to do with it, obviously. Not fishing too heavy as well. It can have a substantial bearing on how much you catch on that day. Fishing as light as possible means fishing the sinker weight as light as possible. It's common knowledge to fish 3 to 6 kilo line off the beach for whiting. But not so common. People use sinker weights that are very small. I mean, the fact is that is a heavier or worm attached to a bit of fishing line and a heavy sinker? Of course not. This. Ooh, stingray. Is it? There's something nasty. It's a nice flathead, mate, yes. Oh, how good is that? I reckon it'd be about 60 centimetres. Woo! Look at the size of that mouth. I'm wrapped. Okay, so keen to see what it measures now. Mate, 59 centimetres. 59 centimetres. Woo! How good's that? Pick up a beach worm. I would love to have got that on 4 pound line and a plastic. Oh well. Near 60 centimetre flathead, two whiting around 36 centimetres each. 32 centimetre whiting, nice limit on at least about 30 centimetres, 29, 30. Pretty good. Loading up. that bugger hooked down deep too. Close to legal though too. So it's hooked quite deep, this fish, as you can see. And that's on a size 2 hook. Alright, so number 2 comes off there. And I use hooks that aren't stainless steel as well. Just hoping that the hook will rust out and fall out. I didn't yank it as well. If you yank it, you're gonna probably hit vital organs like the blood vessels and tear the gill and so forth. So the fact is, it's, if you're gonna release it or it's too small, you probably miss on the harm. Okay, so I moved another gutter, so I'm not getting bites other than undersized whiting. I moved to the other side of the gutter and fast drift, undersized whiting, that was it. I move around. Best not to have your body here sprawled out like all over the place, otherwise you're probably reluctant to move then. More hassle to move if you've got gear everywhere, so just be compact, be neat, keep on the move. Here we go, I've got a pickup already. Pays to move, isn't it? There you go. First cast of the new gutter. Solid 32 centimetre whiting at least. Wonderful. Okay, that's in the bag. Alright, so back out there. Running out of light, you can probably see the light dropping now. So prime time, right on that prime time. Whiting up there. Oh, the whiting in a bream. There you go. Both undersized. Tell you what, it's fantastic when you get 240 centimetre plus whiting hooked at the same time. Great fun. There you go. Ooh. That's something.
prime time and whiz fish. Lots of tiny whiting. I'm going to be packing in now. It's nearly dark. It's about to pour as well. So I'll show you what the bag of fish was. Nice flatty, whiting.
Beautiful.
Nice feed of fish. Not a huge bag of fish, but just a nice feed of fish. There you go. Bag of fish, whiting fishing. My catch being the flatty. And the bream, how good's that? So if you'd like to see more videos, please share, like, and subscribe. We'll have more coming soon. Cheers.